Hello, Mr. Nyren here. So I'm playing Warcraft Total War. I've done some changes. I've deactivated the Night Elven Large Town because it caused extreme lag. I haven't removed any of the other custom settlements for them, but I suspect more of them will cause lag. So I'm gonna try and play in all of them, and if all of them cause lag, then I will remove them. We might reskin the High Elven or Blood Elven settlements into Night Elven, if that's the case, because the Elder Scrolls custom settlements, despite looking perfect for the Night Elves, the Aldemir ones, they cause extreme lag when as soon as the army is fighting on the walls or inside of the city, it lags like every second, so it's pretty much unplayable. At least on my computer, and it's a gaming computer from 2013. No other custom settlement or vanilla city cause lagging, but the Elder Scrolls cities cause extreme lag. And of course, I'm gonna choose a lag-free mod over nice cities. So, but yeah, and we are also using some memory editing tools now, so we have single man giants. They will probably crash, but I still wanted to try it. I remade the EDU again in order to try and make them less likely to crash. You see, I have lowered the numbers of certain units, so that will decrease the chance of the game crashing, because if you overreach a certain polygon limit, then the game will crash. But if I reduce the numbers of soldiers in certain numerous units, for example the Goblin Militia had like 250, if I reduce such units in numbers, that will reduce the chance of the game crashing when I have giants on the battle. Okay, we are gonna play as the Naga and the Blood Elves. We will have medium battle difficulty because that's fair, otherwise the AI would get bonuses. I've also deactivated the population growth because I thought it was too fast or too quick, so settlements could upgrade way too fast, and I didn't like that. The only reason that feature is there is because Bant wanted to be able to get later units fast. He doesn't have any patience with, you know, having bad units in the beginning. But I enjoy starting with like building from scratch and moving up, and it shouldn't be a quick matter. But the armies are still elite at the start. We have no giants, I believe, at the start because I removed them from the desk strat. So we will wait on the giants until like late game. Okay, so we won't have any issues, I believe, in the early game anyway. If the Night Elven cities still crash, I mean if most of the Night Elven cities lag, then I will exit this campaign and restart it, and of course delete the rest of their cities and let them be vanilla for now. Maybe I will add the High Elven cities for the Night Elves, but keep the walls from this if I can. Okay, so no battle time limit, manage all cities. We won't disable the console, I like using it. Okay, and yeah, that's it. Start the game. Frostmourne hungers. Hortus Menethil, Death Knight. So we're in the game. Capital city, Silver Moon, as the Blood Elves or the Sindori, as they're known in their language. Faction leader is King Kael Tas. I've changed the bodyguard because they had a mage bodyguard, and I'm using the Immersion Mod too. and mage units and rangers, etc., they don't work with immersion mod because the camera will zoom in on the projectile when it's fired. They had to use a different bodyguard, but the generals are still the same. So we're still using the Bloodwing Vindicators as the captain and the Blood Mage as the general. But the bodyguard is different. Okay, so King Kel'thas is leader and he's also the greatest general. We have 4 generals. Regions control 2, cities 1, castles 1. And we have fought no battles. Year is 616 after the Dark Portal. Turn number is 1. Domination hold 50 regions, including Tranquillian, Silver Moon, Sun, Welfare Breeze, Sun Sail, Unchorage, Eliminate Factions, Lordaeron, the Scourge, the Amani. We have 14,800 turns remaining. Okay, let's see here. We will go for Dirt Roads first. We need a better economy. And this army can move closer to the city. We have a spy here. We can spy on the enemy. Scourge has some areas here with great armies. No frost worms in them. Okay, next turn. Now we're in the Naga, the ally of the Blood Elves of the Sindori. So the Naga, they are allied to the Blood Elves, and the Blood Elves, by the way, were allied only to the Naga, and they are to all the Scourge, the Scarlet Crusade, the Amani, and the minor factions. The Naga are allied to the Sindori, also known as the Blood Elves, and they are allied to the Burning Legion. Their enemies are the Terramor, the Night Elves, the Scourge, the Scarlet Crusade, the Vrykul, Ankirai, and the Amani. So the faction, capital city is Eldareth, faction leader is Demon Hunter Illidan, greatest general is Demon Hunter Illidan as well. Generals are, we have 9 generals, regions control 9, cities 8, castles 1, battles won 0, battles lost 0, year is 616 after the Dark Portal. Turn number is 1, domination hold 50 regions, eliminate factions, Lordaeron, the Night Elves, and the Scourge. Alright, we'll place this in the middle. I forgot to do that with the Blood Elves. So we have the Demon Hunter Illidan in Eldareth. We have Nyentus in Nashvel. We have Warlord Kalitresh in Ruins of Bashalaran. We have Lady Vash in Sadshor. We have Lord Sinslayer in the Ruins of Amat Aran. And we have Atop the Bloodcursed in Bloodmist. We have General Skishes in Solarsal. And we have Warlord Thristis in the Ruins of Metistra. And we have Via in Rippler Strand. And this is the Frozen Throne campaign, by the way. Retinue expands Demon Hunter Illidan. Let's go for some roads here too. We need better economy. In Eldareth we can go for the mines. We will ignore the settlements that can't build economic buildings. We go for the roads in that city as well. And in Solarsal we go for the roads. Sadshor will go for the roads as well. Alright, we're done. We can't recruit any units this turn. So I'm gonna use sheet to handle dragon armies. Excuse me. I'm gonna use sheet to handle the dragon army over here and another place, because dragons are still prone to CTD, but now they are only 1 per unit, but they still have an army. I don't want to risk a CTD. I am prepared to risk a CTD with my own guys or enemies like official factions, but not entire armies with giants. Alright, So we will move this army towards this area. Arkoran village. Village. Okay. Next time. Princess return. Prince Artus Menethil is back from his journey to Northrend, but he is not the same person anymore. Influenced by a dark sword named Fostmarn, he has turned against his own people and now has joined the ranks of the Scourge. Alright. End of turn report. So the Scourge is the strongest faction overall. They have the strongest military, they have the best production, and they have the largest population. Undead population. The best financial situation is currently held by the Burning Legion. Construction report. In Silver Moon we have dirt roads, and in Sunwell, the Sunwell, we have also dirt roads. Okay, so let's go for paved roads, and in the Sunwell we go for a trader or mines. We'll go for mines. Alright, next turn. A new general in Eldareth. Can move out this unit now. End of the turn report, same as for the Blood Elves. We have four dirt roads finished in four different areas. Okay, settlements in Eldareth. We are still constructing mines in ruins of Metistra. I believe we can't do anything in these currently. Let's see here. Let's go for Hunter's Lodge to enable us to build the basic range units. You need them against the Night Elves. So Murloc Swamp Runners and Naga Ambushers, they are Javeliners, they are pretty bad, but you need to start somewhere. We can go for an Elven Trader in Solar Cell. And in South Shore, we can also go for an Elven Trader. In Ripley Strand, we'll go for paved roads. And in Eldareth we are constructing the mines. Okay, in this area we will now attack the dragons. As you can see, they only have one unit per unit, but I believe that will crash still because they are so many, so we will do this. Ottovin attacker. Started to lag and click the auto resolve. Hope it will solve itself. So I'm using some memory editing for the units, so they are one, etc. Maybe that's why we ended up with an issue. I clicked on the tab button and it solved it. So we won that battle. Just walk in. Yeah, we will let them have it. I won't do anything now there. Alright, trade increase. We are winning first. Resistance is futile in Amber Ledge. We are mean leader next turn. You're back. Blood Elves, end of turn report. The Night Elves have the best production, that's the only change from last time. Alright, next turn we can't do much. We have a new general. Let's move her. Can now can't attack yet. Need a building where we can recruit troops. Go for dirt roads first in Eldareth. And that's it. End of turn report, same as for the Blood Elves. We have mines in Eldareth. Trade increase. Idrakes Coilscar feels unappreciated. might have some units to move in the east of Kalimdor. Let's move out some troops. Fast forward that. Couldn't move there with that army. So I have the general still in ruins of Emmet Aaron. A rebel army of three ants there. They merged the army, good. Night Elven army is outside of ruins of Bashal Aaron. Don't think it's a good idea to attack. Maybe we will attack. Because we can reinforce the army with this army. Right, so we had one unit of ancient dragon turtles here. They are two instead of three, that's probably bad. We have a Knight of the General here, scenarios. Right, we will move a general here too. So the enemy army under Captain Sarin has one unit of Knight Elven, Knight Elf Priestesses, one unit of Avengers, one unit of Wardens, one unit of Fairy Dragons, one unit of Moonstrikers, one unit of Night Elven Warriors, one unit of Huntresses, and one unit of Tree Ants. Alright. Save the game. And we will let this army be AI controlled. Fight the battle on the battle map. Yes, I am the cautious one, and sometimes my caution has saved us as much as your decisiveness, Kiliaden, your instinctive impetuosity, Archimond. Start deployment. We need to move the general back a bit. He's not in danger. Because usually my force would start closer to the enemy. I don't know where the ally will start, but probably far away. Start the battle. And we need to change one thing. I need to see the radar map. Let it be sliding in and out. So the ally is over here, entering the battle. Their army. Alright, it might crash due to that ancient dragon turtle. Alright, let's move the unit towards the army and fast forward. So a unit of Wrath of Shara here, the bodyguard unit of the Naga, and one custom model for this general because he is a Wrath of Shara general. But the generic general isn't a Wrath of Shara, the captain is, however. Here we have some Guardians of the Abyss. Some Naga Seacallers, mages, but they are as good as a archer unit. We have some Javeliners, the Naga Ambushers. Another unit of Wrath of Shara with a custom model of Wrath of Shara. We have some Naga Sea Witches, very dangerous mages. And we have more Naga Seacallers and Ambushers. Here we have the Dragon Turtle, Ancient Dragon Turtle, used one now, good. They can crash because they have very high poly count. So if the game crashes now, it's due to that Dragon Turtle, I believe. Where is my, oh man. Here it is. Move up. Sand horn. I know that with the memory editing tool and the new EDU, Giants will be less likely to crash, but they can still crash. I played the Burning Legion before and it didn't crash for a lot of battles, and then all of a sudden it started to crash like for 3 battles in a row. However, I didn't use the updated EDU back then, where I have lowered the numbers of certain units. Alright, let's tab out and go to third person mod and start this. So I want to control the general if I can. I'm not sure it works with the other memory editing tool, because this is also some form of memory editing. Yeah, it seems to work. Awesome. I am controlling the general in battle. You need to slow down. Don't want it to be that fast. It seems to move very slowly, this general. So you are controlling this Rat of Shara general in battle. He will be easily killed by cavalry. Sound the horn. I like how these look. They didn't look bugged. Some of the Night Elven units look very bugged, like the archers. Their arms are distorted. That's because the Medieval 2 animation didn't fit the taller Night Elves and Trolls, but I believe Bantu made a mistake. He kept the original size of the Night Elves and the Trolls. Maybe it's good for the Giant Trolls. They look good because they use the Moblins as base, but the Night Elves used humans as base, and the humans are actually smaller than the Night Elves. They are shorter. So I believe he shouldn't have kept the original size of the Night Elves. He should have made them human size. Then they would have looked perfect. Because he decided to keep the Night Elven size, the arms got distorted and they look very glitched. The Blood Elves look kind of better, but some of them still have arms that look wrong. So I believe it was a bad decision to keep their size. He should have just resized the elves into the same size as humans. Then they would have looked good. But as you can see, the Rat of Shara look very good. So we can zoom in on a general like this. We can also zoom in on any unit we are controlling if they are fighting, but not on the AI control unit to help out in the battle. If I can, yeah, I could. We will try to kill some of these. I wanted him to actually help, but not die, but he will probably die. Good, awesome. Fuck, they had many here, and I can't retreat, I'm too slow. So I need to send my bodyguard, but it's too far away, I will probably die, I fucked up this battle. I sent my bodyguard, but I died. Too bad. We fucked up that fight. So we have zoomed in on our bodyguard instead. You can see some fighting at the front. Some of the Night Elves look pretty good, but yeah, he should have kept the human size, then the arms would have looked much better. Okay, but these units look fine. I believe the archers are the ones that look really bad in terms of arms. Might be some others too. I like this view. It's click on the UI and hide it. Don't need to show it anymore. Let's exit that text there. So let's just enjoy the fight. I like the zoomed in view. I always like that in modern games like Total War Warhammer 2. Yeah, if Bant is gonna remake the elves, then I believe he should resize them to fit the humans and their skeleton. Yeah, they would be smaller than in World of Warcraft, but they would look perfect. Instead of being the right size, but having bugged or glitched arms, etc. Okay. The rats of Shara are pretty large, pretty huge. Don't like that the AI used the sea colors in melee, they're supposed to be their archers. So that's a waste, but sometimes the AI is stupid. So these are moon strikers, they are also missile units. Shit, they sent in the huntresses on their panthers. They are dangerous. Ranged units can also fight in melee. Yeah, I like this unit. The Moonstrikers looked good. Their arms didn't look too bad. But the archers still really need better arms. They look really bad when you look at them in close range. These huntresses are good looking too. The immersion mod. So if the general dies, we can zoom in on the captain, and if he dies, we'll zoom in on the nearest unit. We can't use it on AI-controlled armies, only on the armies we are controlling, and we are only controlling one unit of general's bodyguard here. We have already lost it because the general died, so it's pretty much dead. So it doesn't matter if all of them die. They killed another one. Shit, the huntresses are taking us down here. Another unit here of huntresses. Really cool third person mod where we look at things like in World of Warcraft. It's like the same point of view as if we were in World of Warcraft. Everything looks so big. Killed another one. He lost the entire unit. There are no units left. He can't zoom in anymore. Slow motion now. Take a look on the battlefield. So the AI used Naga Sivitches in melee. Not good. A lot of our troops died. Maybe we shouldn't see how many they have killed. Would ruin the immersion maybe. Now we don't know. They still have troops left. Here we have Naga ambushers in melee. Their melee weapon. They killed a lot of our units. including the Guardians of the Abyss. We have some left here. Fighting the Wardens. So, what about the Dragon Turtle and such? It's hard to know where they are when we can't see on the minimap. We need to activate the minimap if we want to know exactly where units are. I might actually do that. So here we have the Huntresses. The Panthers and the Moonstrikers. The units that killed our bodyguard. They will probably win thanks to their cavalry. Alright, I changed my mind. We need to have the radar visible so I can know where my units are. We have some units over here. Enemies. Knight of Priestesses, mages. They may have taken out the Dragon Turtle. I love the view of this battle. Shame I didn't control the larger army, then I could have watched it in close combat. Okay, there's some allies over here. Retreating Naga Seacallers. Here even more retreating Naga Seacallers. Got an allied unit over here as well. Retreating Naga Ambushers. Yeah, they have killed the ancient Dragon Turtle with their mages, I'm pretty sure about that. They are weak against mages, can be killed in like one shot or so. Here it is, dead. Otherwise they are very strong. Okay. Let's speed up. No need to use slow motion anymore. We have probably lost this battle. 86% allies killed, 84% enemies killed. It's a very equal battle. Between the Night Elves and the Naga. Just the garrisons of two of the ruins. And their Moonstrikers, one of the better looking units. Of course I like the archers the most when it comes to their aesthetic, but their arms are so glitched that they look bad. Otherwise they would be the best looking unit of the Elves. Send in the hunters in melee to kill off our ambushers here. Yeah, they have won the battle. Unit routes Naga Seacallers. So this could be a let's play, but If I found that every Night Elven city lags, I can't even play in them, then I need to restart it. And this time I won't just remove the one settlement, I will remove all their custom settlements. With the exception of maybe Nordrasil, the tree. I don't know if that one will crash, but probably not, it's just a tree. But I might be wrong. Alright, clear defeat. Warlord Tristis had 101 men, lost all of them, killed 94, pretty bad result. I managed to get him killed because I were stupid. Warlord Calidres, 995 men, lost 921, have 74 remaining, killed 503, that's better but still not good. The Night Elves had 699 men, so pretty much 700 men, killed 500. Kill 955, that's very good, and lost 513. And the detailed statistics. The best unit of the allied army was the Guardians of the Abyss. They killed a lot. One of them killed 167 and the other 150. The Ancient Dragon Turtle killed zero. Their mages took it out before it could kill anyone. Okay, our general killed 94. And we're done with the battle. It sucks, I lost my hero. So the remnants of the army retreated to the ruins of Bashal Aran, where I will merge them. So we merge them, and Noble Death, Warlord Kalidres, and the Noble Death, Warlord Tristes. She lost both our generals there, not good. The rest will defend. We have an army here too. Okay, in Northrend we have this force. We could leave one unit of Myrmidons and move the rest towards the Gorloks over there. Gorloks and Murlocs. Murlocs led by Gorloks, I believe. And this army can't move. I probably already done this. Yeah, I did. Alright, next time. Bride presented, we don't need a bride. The council are greatly impressed by your leadership and would like you to accept this humble offering as a token of past and future endeavors. Source, Council of Nobles, reward, you have been rewarded with 3,000 florins. Okay, and then in Silver Moon we are still constructing the paved roads. And in the Sunwell we are going to build, construct an elven port there. And can't do much more. But relations improved with the Naga, we have good relations. Construction complete. In Sunwell we have new mines. And end of turn report. Kasmodan has the best production in the world, otherwise the same as before. They took that slot from the Night Elves, I believe. Alright, next turn, we have a new general, we have three generals in Eldareth, and a Night Elven army moving towards the city. Let's move the leader back. Alright, and keep it like that for now. End of turn report, same as for the Blood Elves. Trade increase, Lady Vash feels unappreciated. Construction completed, in we have dirt roads in Eldareth, and Elven traders in Solarsal and South Shore, and the Hunter's Lodge in Nashville. Okay, in Eldareth we'll go for the paved roads. And believe in Sachor, you can go for the Murloc slave pens, will enable the basic troops, Murloc slaves, Murloc tide hunters, Murloc shore crawlers, and Murloc swamp runners. So go for that in Sachor. And in Rippler Strand we are still constructing the paved roads. We will not do anything in those smaller areas. And in Nashville we'll go for the Hunter's Hall. Will enable us to recruit Murloc Swamp Runners, Naga Ambushers, Naga Seacallers, Naga Sea Witches, and Saturn Hellcallers, the range units that we need against the Night Elves. We can recruit Naga Ambushers and Murloc Swamp Runners already, so we will do that in Nashville. In Solar Cell, we will also go for the Murloc Slave Pens. I believe in we missed any of the good areas. Okay, we might have some units to recruit. In Solar Cell we can go for a merchant, we will do that. Still had a vanilla portrait in Sachor as well. I believe we are done. done. Then we can move the troops, I believe. So we have an arm here. Let's move him towards our burden. So we can't reach this time. They have a huge arm there under General Brawl Bearmantle, which is a druid general. He has a unique druid bodyguard. And his, model. His bodyguard is the Night Elven Sentries. He also has Druids of the Claw, Night Elven Spearmen, Hippogriff Riders, Night Elven Archers. Yeah, they look good, but their arms are distorted. Mounted Sentries, Night Elf Priestesses, Mounted Night Elven Warriors, Night Elven Warriors, more Spearmen, Treants, Fairy Dragons, Huntresses, Moonstrikers, and Wardens. So this city is a large town, there should not be custom anymore. Okay, we have the army in Northrend to move as well. We'll attack this city. It's held by Russell, a general, Gorlok general, mage unit, very good, and units of Murlocs, but they have some Gorloks too. Pretty good unit. We can't read their description. So Naga has access to Murlocs, but they do not have access to Gorloks. They are rebel only. Gorlok Oracles. Maybe we could add them as regional recruitment units from those areas for the Naga. Because they are still like fish creatures. Okay. Night Elves have too strong a force for me to attack them. Let's go to the Eastern Kingdoms. We have a Lord or an army here. And their prince, Magroth. A bodyguard, a knight's bodyguard, a generic bodyguard. We have a rebel unit outside to kill the rebels. Okay, I believe we can could leave the mages inside of the city and move out. They have a human spear militia unit and human footmen. Let's just auto-resolve that one. We need to exit this, by the way, after each battle, or we risk crashing when we start a new battle. Okay. They are just like one or two units I will just auto-resolve. No point playing against such few units. Unless they are an official army like the Lordran are here. Trait decrease, Lady Vash feels unappreciated. Trait increase, Lady Vash winning first. Okay. So I believe we will just return to the city. We won't attack Lordran. Too weak in this region to spend our troops. Let's end the turn. Back to Blood Elves. End of turn report. Stormwind has the best production in the world. That's the only change. We have paved roads in Silver Moon. And now we will go for mines in Silver Moon. And continue to construct the Elven port in the Sunwell. Can't recruit any units. We have a spy outside of Fairbreeze. So their units are a general's bodyguard, a death knight bodyguards, a generic bodyguard. They have crypt lords, skeleton archers, abominations, death knights, dismounted death knights, necromancers, cold wraiths, mages, vulgar baboon hackers, like golems in size, crypt lords, crypt fiends, gargoyles, skeleton raiders, undead soldiers, myriad champions, Urgul flesh rippers, undead champions, and banshees as mages, and undead halberds and undead surgeons. They have strong force there. And over here they have another army, similar units. A general in the city, he also has a death knight bodyguard. Some of their bodyguards are liches. Okay, our bodyguard, by the way, is a blood mage bodyguard, because this is a historical general, but generic general isn't. I believe Kel'Thas also has a blood mage bodyguard still. Yeah, but the generic ones won't have that. This guy also probably has some unique bodyguard, Brightwing Vindicators, like in lore. Alright. So we are done next turn. Candidate for adoption, another general. We get the new general each turn with the Naga. Thanks to adoptions. Relations improved. The Burning Legion, we have good relations. Trade increase. Sakras' Stormcaller feels unappreciated. We still got increase and not decrease. Recruitment report. In Nashville we have Naga Ambushers, Moloch's Swamp Runners, and in Solasal and Sartre we have a Merchant. Okay, and we have paved roads in Ripless Strand. End of turn report same as for the Blood Elves. Let's attack someone. We need to attack someone. Let's move this army towards the Night Elves. Let's check the construction. We'll ignore the smaller areas. So in Ripless Strand we'll go for the Elven Trader now. Increases tradable goods, very good. Same with the roads, etc. Okay, and we're pretty much done. We have a merchant we can move out here, but I don't know if there are any resources for her. Or him, it's a him, it's a Guardians of the Abyss model. Okay, and we have another agent in South Shore. Should be resources here. Here we have a resource. There are 10 Florins grain. Let's move out the merchant there. We have a Scourge area, Terran Mill here. Dismounted Death Knights, among other units, are there. I want a stronger army before I attack from South Shore. Let's check the recruitment. Should be able to recruit in some areas. Maybe not this turn. We did the last turn. Okay, so the Night Elves might actually attack Ruins of Matistra. Let's move some reinforcements there towards the front. Well, this army can now finally besiege our burden. We need siege engines because the Dragon Turtles will crash if we try to use them against the wall or gate, because they are not a ranged unit. They are elephants, so the game thinks they can work against the walls, because in Rome Total War melee elephants could actually attack walls, but they can't in level 2, it will crash. We'll try to move towards this city. We couldn't reach it this time. Alright, next turn. Back is the Blood Elves, end of turn report. The Naga has the best production, that's good news. Relations improved with the Naga, we have very good relations, good. Elven port, we have an Elven port in the Sunwell. My plan is to combine the Naga army with the Blood Elven army. That's why I don't want to use the Naga army in South Shore yet. They should be passive for a while. We need to probably attack the Scourge. So I guess we will attack the Scourge in Fair Breeze. Have a siege engine. They kind of want. We might actually attack that siege engine. Let's save the game. Start battle. We can't let them reinforce the town. Need to be aggressive with the Blood Elves, otherwise the Naga will probably be crushed before we even reach them. Start deployment. So this custom settlement is Beon's Halls from the 4.0 version of Third Age. I got permission from Leo Civil UFs to use this settlement. Of course the walls are bugged, but it kind of fit the texture is missing, but it kind of fit the undead. I used this settlement because of the recoil. I might change it, but the problem is we don't have any custom undead cities, with the exception of the Shadow Temple from Hyrule Total War and the graveyard from Elder Scrolls Total War. And as you know, the Elder Scrolls settlements crash a lot. So let's move all the armies back a bit in case they have long range. We don't want them to use any mages on our troops. The exception of maybe our siege stuff is, as I recall, we only had one siege engine, so we'll use it to attack the gate. We'll have we need to do this. Let's slide command. Loose formation and start the battle, attack the walls. So we have a unique crew for the Blood Elves. Looks like this. It's not a militia unit, it's a unique crew. And have the Blood Elven army over here. We'll try to destroy the walls with these guys. Hawk Talon Wall Throwers. So they have the Warhammer portraits there because the engine is from Warhammer. So yeah, description also seems to be no, it's probably for the High Elves of Warcraft. So they did have the range, yeah, I knew that. The Necromancer can shoot over the walls against our troops. Hopefully we can take out the gate, but I'm not sure we will be able to do it. They might take out our Hawk Talon Wall Throwers first. This is the only engine of the Elves and the Blood Elves now. High Elves and Blood Elves. Fuck, they sallied out! That's not good. Not good at all. Cheated. Let's send the cavalry against them. Special ability wedge formation, we will use that. We are sending one cavalry unit there. Actually we will send both cavalry units there. The golems there too. So the initiates have the civilian animation from Hyrule Total War, that's why they move around like that. Fuck the mages, what the fuck are you doing? So they are firing on the enemy. Forgot to deactivate that. Meaning they will kill my own troops. Don't want that at all. you activate all the fire at will options for the mages. Can't allow that. So general is a vindicator unit, I see. Shit, we killed some of our own there. Not good. What do they have here? So we are hunting them. The Silver Guard Lancers. They will probably take out this siege engine if you're unlucky. So the Necromancers cause a plague. It will hurt our enemies if they are inside of that fog. I mean, hurt our troops if they are inside of the fog. Our Arcane Guardians are fighting their gargoyles. Send the cavalry towards their cavalry instead. What are they sending out now? Shit, abominations. Actually, send this cavalry unit against their gargoyles. And send the Arcane Guardians against their abominations. So the cavalry will take care of their gargoyles there. They are, believe they are light cavalry. Very weak cavalry. Let's attack them from behind. So we have some pikemen here, that's good. They are good against their cavalry. Perfect. Let's order them to attack the cavalry. And cavalry attacks from behind as well. Gargoyles are... Yeah, they have unbreakable units, yes. Attack those gargoyles, cavalry. I don't know why these didn't do shred. You should also help against them. We have more cavalry here. Crypt lords. Actually, they sent out mages. It's time for us to attack their mages, I believe. Their banshees will be attacked by our priests. And our Arcane Guardians are finally fighting their abominations. We need a cavalry unit against that crypt unit. So let's attack it instead with the Blood Knights. So the Banshees are pretty good. Need to help our Arcane Guardians there. Like how the capes move like this when they ride forward. Banta did a great job on those guys. On the cavalry. Okay, and on the Arcane Guardians they look perfect. And the Crypt Lords. Okay, so sent in some cavalry there. Our priests have started to fire on their banshees. New projectile, very fitting for them. These are not the priests, these are the arcanists, their best mage besides the bodyguard. Very good projectile. Killed a lot of their banshees now. The undead have like half their units being fan-made and the other half being like well, Warcraft units. Fuck, they are charging with those crypt lords. Hunt them down. You messed up. You were supposed to stop them. Let's attack with the spearman here. Too. Before they kill my troops. Fuck. It's not good that they took out my range units too. Let's retreat with them. Kill their cavalry. What the fuck are they doing? Ah, they had two units of crypt lords. That explains it. So the spellbreakers are spearmen, so they should be better against them. Kill a few of our mages there. Let's move them behind the army actually. Good, they are surrounded. Kill all of them, they are too dangerous. One of their best units. There they are with even more. Let's charge with the cavalry. The abominations could be fighting the pikemen or elven silver guards. So add more cavalry here. Who are they fighting? Some gargoyles. Fuck that unit, it managed to somehow escape my cavalry. Let's move this unit back. I don't like using infantry against cavalry. We lost the battle because they took out my siege engines. I had no way of destroying their gate. Alright, close defeat. Halderon Brightwing had 1932 men, lost 200, and we have 1732 remaining. Killed 276 of the enemies. We killed more than we lost, which is good. Not the Plaguebringer of the Scourge had 1546 men, lost 235, so they lost 35 more than us. Men remaining 1311 and killed 190 plus 2 additional units when they were routing. Alright, we lost the battle because they took out the siege engine. They were hard to fight. Let's accept and retreat. Relations worsened. We have poor relations with the Scourge. Scourge, now it's very poor actually. Okay, in the sun, well, we can construct a hunter's lodge. The port has been completed. Let's go for some transport trips. Transport is a quick boat used to transport troops. They can't attack, they have no weapons. Since it has no weapons, it should be accompanied by a warship for its security, so it's just for transporting troops. Okay, and let's move the spy over here. And the next turn, back to Naga. Solosar, we have Maluk Slaypens completed, and in Sartor as well. Relations improved, we have good relations with the Sindore. Relations worsened, we have poor relations with Terramore. Okay, let's move on, general, after Illidan himself. They have an orc army inside of Splinter Tree. Good attack. And then with this army, it should be ready to attack. So we will do that. Don't need the last siege tower. Let's just attack. The enemy has some troops. Roll a bear mantle there. Start the battle. so it's a vanilla settlement because lag too much otherwise. Good. Fuck, it crashed. It must have been one of the units. We'll have to restart. Okay, Warcraft. We need to start this first, otherwise we can't start the game now. And then execute. Executable. So we're back in the game. Let's load. If I'm unlucky, I might have not saved before that battle. Then we might be in the beginning of the battle of the Blood Elves instead. That would be bad. I don't know why it crashed. Yeah. So we don't have any CTD friendly units. I don't know why they don't have that either. Let's just start it again. Might be the dragon turtles. They shouldn't crash, but sometimes they might crash anyway. Okay. Start deployment. Army to be placed far away. We don't need sea witches as the unit using the ram. We'll use this Myrmidon unit at the loose formation. They will be ready to destroy the gate. And the tower. Manned by Guardians of the Abyss. We placed there to attack the wall. Should have some ladders too. Rat of Ashara bodyguard. Don't need a bodyguard to control the ram. I need Myrmidons if we have that. To do that for us. This bodyguard, yeah. Some ambushers. Ambushers could do it then. They didn't have any fitting or suitable infantry. They will also attack the walls. Ambushers are kinda bad against the Night Elves anyway. Unless we have anything that is a melee unit. No, we don't. Closest thing is the bodyguard there. Actually, we will place this unit here to attack the walls and change my mind with the Myrmidons. The Myrmidon units could actually help by providing fire. They will probably not have the range to reach the enemy. We will still do this. So the Naga Sea Colors are our archers. They will be loose formation and single line. Move them forward too. And we have the actual mages. We had another sequeler here too. Let's see, we'll do this and we need to have all the sequelers in one unit. I to see if we had any more. Only the bodyguard there. And some oracles, sea witches, and Medusa matriarchs. Okay. Let's place the Naga sea callers in one group and lose formation, single line. And one line there, and then we have the Medusa matriarchs, lose formation, fire arrows. Let's move them there. We have the mages, the oracles. Actually, they can be placed over here. Lose formation. And we have a witch, sea witch unit too. Can place here maybe. Okay, and the bodyguard will be moved closer. We'll ignore the dragon turtles. Start the battle. Let's attack the walls and the gates. Probably forgot to man the one of the ladder units with the bodyguard. I see that now. So one ladder unit here manned by Guardians of the Abyss. We have the gate. I mean the ram manned by Myrmidons. We have the siege tower manned by another unit of Guardians of the Abyss. Hope they won't take it out. Some mage or something. They have druids after all. Their bodyguard is probably a druid. No, it isn't. The general is. So no lag now, but they had a druid unit here. They are dangerous, they are mages, they could probably destroy the siege towers. Alright, they had it with those ranged units. Let's attack them. Range units if we can. It didn't do anything. Let's try the matriarchs. Yeah, they are moving. Good. Our mage units. Fuck, they have this long range. I believe we will. I have no choice but to move these units back. They killed a lot of my Guardians of the Abyss before they could reach the city. That's fine, I guess, that we only lost Guardians of the Abyss. But where are my mages? Sea callers there. Might have killed my sea witches too, which isn't good. Here we have sea callers, Naga oracles, they will attack the walls, attack the druids of the claw. No, they will attack the night elven archers. Well, these guys are attacking the druids of the claw. Sea witches here. They will also attack the druids. The claw. Fuck that. You're supposed to destroy the gate. So our guardians of the abyss are at least doing something right. Here we have another unit attacking their walls, defended by Night Elven archers. Oh, they drop the ram and attack. Actually, we need the dragon. Fuck! It crashed when I used the dragon turtle. Now I know why it crashed. because they can't attack gates. So when we click on the dragon turtle in a siege battle, it will crash. I see. Let's start it up again. We need to first restart this program, I forgot. So we'll need to redo all the preparations again. Load game, load campaign. Actually, we might actually wait on the second siege tower before attacking that city, because we need it. The turtles can't attack gates without crashing. We can't even click on them without crashing. Otherwise, I would have used them to attack the troops there at the gate. We won't attack. We'll continue to build that tower. Check the recruitment and stuff. Had another city here where we could build some stuff. Let's try to see. Yeah, we could use a wooden castle. Let's upgrade. And in South Shore we could also use a wooden castle. Let's upgrade. We'll upgrade Ruins of Matistra as well, it's under threat. And the Ruins of Bashal Aran could now be upgraded, we have money. Ruins of Amat Aran 2. And we're done. The Blood Mist City could also be upgraded. And Amber Sledge. So we're done with the construction. Check the recruitment. So if you try to select a dragon turtle or other elephant unit in a siege battle, it will crash. At least if you have the mouse on the gate or walls. That's because they lack projectiles. Let's recruit Murloc Swamp Runners in South Shore. We're done. The armies of Ildan and the other general will continue to siege. Now we can finally attack this area. Attack the Murlocs. We don't need siege equipment. Let's fight this battle against the Murlocs and Gorlocs here. Save the game first. In case we will experience a crash. This is a village, so we can use the turtles, there is no gate. Fight the battle on the battle map. So the plague in Lordaeron, the citadels of Nordra and the slaughtering of the elves, it was all just to prepare for some huge demonic invasion. Yes, in time you will find that our entire history has been shaped by the coming conflict. The coming conflict. Kaltisad, Archleash of the Scourge. Okay, start deployment. The general here is this woman. Vidya, she uses a Sivich custom model, and I believe we will group the unit, but deselect the general wherever she was. So these will be one group. They will be AI controlled. We'll start the battle. And we'll go for the settlement. So the enemy, they have Murlocs and Gorlocs. The new unit, the only unit of this type that isn't available to the Naga. They are mages, the only good unit. He has such a bodyguard and some others. So that's the Gorlocks and Murlocks there, holding this area. I need to find the army. General. Here we have the general. Right. We'll see if they move. They are moving good. Let's tab out. We need to use the death edition so we can control the general. Good. We are now in control of Vidya herself. Awesome. She looks great. Of course, when she gets blooded, the model won't look as great anymore, but otherwise they will have like dirt anyway. Hope the AI will actually do something and not just stand there. So this is the general Vidya, Sivich general, a unit of Hydras here. The AI seem to have trouble moving. Okay, we will do this. The mages. Let's check the UI. It's annoying when I can't see it. Slide. So the mages. The ambushers will be moved out. And the matriarchs and sea callers. It's about half the army. And then we will order them manually to attack the arranged units. All of them will be loose formation, by the way. And they might have some javeliners too. Attack them. And let's pause so we can order all at once to attack. Actually, we will use the ambushers against their javeliners. Then we use the sea callers against mages, Gorlocks, wherever they are. Seem to have moved them. We need to activate the radar too, so I can see where the enemy is. Here we had some troops. One of them could attack this unit instead. One of the ambushers. Then we have the Gorlocks there. We will attack with the sea callers. And we have some units in the back. Are they ranged? No. Doesn't look like it. Okay. We have a Sivich general or captain. I believe it's a captain. No, it's a general actually. No, officers. All of the Murlocs have Sivich officers. Forgot that. So they're just officers. Okay. So for our infantry. Time to attack their infantry too. So we started over there. We're gonna move all the way around here. No, I don't think so. We can move. And the Rat of Shara unit is its own unit here. We won't touch the Dragon Turtles for now. Let's speed up, we can run. Right, so we are moving. There are some hidden obstacles there, so we had to move to the side. Naga army is moving towards their goal. The guardians of the abyss have stopped to move. Maybe they are waiting for more of them to show up. We need to move through this unit or move back. Got kind of stuck there. It's a shame we can't use Naga in World of Warcraft. I always wanted to place them in World of Warcraft. I played World of Warcraft between 2004 and 2008. Alright, and then Warcraft 3, my favorite factions was were the Naga and the Blood Elves, especially the Naga, so. But in this mod I think I like the Blood Elves even more. So the huge Rat of Ashara there. We'll follow with the army. Guardians of the Abyss are not moving for some reason. So we need to do something about that. Stop the AI control. Pause the game. And they shouldn't be zoomed in. Okay. Enemy army. We'll order these guys to attack again. Some infantry there. More infantry here. Send in the big guys too. And the Rat of Ashara. And bodyguard as well. Okay. And pause. Zoom in on the general. Now we are ready. And let's end the slow motion. So it started to lag like that because of our bodyguard moving. We will stop using it then. Sound the horn there. I love how the Naga look in this mod. Okay. Woo models, but he managed to rig them so they look very, very good. Vidya herself leading a Naga army against Murloc rebels, Gorlok rebels. Gorloks are actually dangerous, they are mages. The only dangerous Murloc unit. The only one the Naga doesn't have access to. They have other mages, of course. They stayed. So this settlement is the storm. The Storm Sora custom settlement from Hyrule War made by Andrei Nephilim or Nephi. But the skin is by Band Chieftain, the modeler of Warcraft of the War. He rigged most of the models, the only exception being the Orc models and some of the old undead models. And some of the human models. Here we have some sea snakes. Naga sea snakes too. They can crash if they are too many, but not otherwise. Took a while to go there. Shows how huge the world is. The Naga are not very fast on land either, they are the slowest faction on land. Which makes sense. I specifically modify their units to be slower than other units. So they have a disadvantage trying to flee the battlefield. We are soon to reach the enemy. I believe the guardians have probably already done so. I'm worried about those Gorlok mages, but nothing else. They might slaughter our infantry. The earth started to shake. Not good. Probably due to those mages. Let's sound the horn. We have some sea colors here. They are firing at the enemy good. So they actually got here first. My ranged units. Let's move around this cliff. We have more of our Naga troops down here. Our ambushers throwing tridents at them. Here things are starting to get dangerous. We have our Hydras fighting over there. Okay. Can't go too close to the enemy. You can see their officer there of one of their Murloc units. I believe that's a Sivich officer of theirs. They're fighting. We have an invisible wall here. Can't move. Yeah. So our Hydras are fighting. Their Murlocs there. We need to move back. They are throwing something at us. Javeliners. Need to retreat with the general. Let the army handle this. Dislike that the earth is shaking. It's probably due to my Medusas or something. They have a very earth-shaking projectile. The ballista or catapult one. The ballista one, I think. Strong, but it's annoying when the earth shakes. Ah, here we have enemies. Fighting ambushers in melee. Sea crawlers. No, they aren't the Medusas aren't involved. I believe it's their mages causing this. They're annoying. Shit, she moved closer to the front when I zoomed out. That's not good. She needs to get out of there immediately. Before the Gorlocks get her. Okay, so we managed to put her in safety. One of the mage units are causing this earthshaking annoying issue. Would have preferred to remove that projectile and use something else. So we will not have to deal with that. Destroys the immersion to some extent. So I believe it could be the Naga Seacrawlers. Or their Gorlock unit. If it's the Gorlock, then we can't do anything about it. But if it's the Seacrawlers, then yeah, their projectile should change. We had no Murlocs in our army, so I believe the reason for the earthshake here. Someone is firing at them, we need to go and check who is doing that. Probably these guys, huh? Our basic archer unit. That sucks, if that's the case. Yeah, it's the sea callers. Fuck. I wish they had a different projectile. Could control them like this, then it won't shake as much. Then we won't be zoomed in. So this sucked. These guys make the earth shake. So I can move around like this and still control her. Moving around like this. Easier when the earth shakes like that. That's a projectile from the enemy. enemy general fall and Rusal, so kill their general. Actually, I'm annoyed at the sea crawlers. Problem is, they are essential. We need them against the archers of the night elves and such. Let's move them back, they are annoying. Try the other mages. So I killed one of their Gorlok units there. While our infantry is fighting their Murlocs over there. Sea witches. Send in some sea witches and the oracles to see if they also cause earthshake. I know the matriarchs will do that. Nice. Good job, Naga ambushers. You did well. Okay, so the ambushers are done here. We could move against their troops. Probably need to restart this anyway, because I believe some of the Night Elven cities that are still custom will lag, so I will probably restart it if that's the case. Then I will also change the projectiles of all the mages that cause earthshake, so I will use a projectile that doesn't cause earthshake. All the mages of the Naga at least, but probably the enemy too, because otherwise, it will still shake when the enemy attacks. Look at the model, it looks awesome. Okay. It's a very narrow passage into the center there. You can see the flags now. Some of the hydras are still alive there as well. Here the enemy is. We can't move closer. Let's move our bodyguard here. What is the percentage? 44% enemies killed, 31% allies killed. We are fast forwarding now. Speed up the arrival of our bodyguard. There is no issue moving the bodyguard when we are staying still, or if we move and are near them. But as long as we are far away from them, we will end up having that issue with walking. So it's better to not move away from them if you're gonna move the those units. I want to attack them from this side, but I need the actual unit first. They're far away. Now they seem to be arriving soon. Sound the horn. They are just walking. Run, for God's sake. 83% enemies killed, 5% health killed. Now we might win before we can actually attack. Yeah, if I use the immersion mode, they always walk and I click on them to move somewhere. I need to specifically click on the fast forward button, I forgot that. That's why it took forever for them to get here. Now the enemy is probably almost defeated. 85% enemies killed, 38% allies killed. They only managed to kill a few more of our troops. Here comes our bodyguard, Wrath of Ashara. Let's stop fast forward, 87% of the enemy is dead. Here's our bodyguard. Time for them to attack. We will move closer too, now that we are protected by the bodyguard. Forward, Rat of Shara. Kill those Murlocs. They are nothing. Gorlocks were a threat. I'm a little too close. Let's move back. See some of the action here against the Murlocs. Awesome. Murlocs also look great in this mod. The ones I don't like are some of the Night Elven units because of their arms. I like the Night Elven faction as a whole. There are some Naga sea snakes fighting in melee. Hydras. Horn with general. Awesome stuff. Really cool battle. Yeah, if I restart the campaign due to lag in Night Elven Cities, then I will also remake the projectiles so that only projectiles that do not cause earthshake will be used. And I only do that for this campaign. It's not something that will be released. Because I want to be able to play like this without the earth shaking when they fire. It's very annoying. Okay. That's also the reason why you don't have range units in the bodyguard, because then the projectile would shake like that. Would make the camera shake like that. Nice view. Naga versus Murlocs. Lost almost all their Murlocs now. They had another unit. Yeah, the blood textures makes it look worse, but without them we would have dirt problems instead that look even worse than the blood. Also, I like having blood, it just didn't look that well in close combat. Oh, special animations there. Ah, fuck, I moved out of it. the melee fight here. They had numbers. And we had strength. Sound the horn with the general again. Fighting here at the front. This is a good view. Now they moved out, which I didn't want. Could be hard to control in this view. Oh, a Hydra entered. They're going berserk there on the Murlocs. It's damaged, the texture got worse. Texture became worse. If I remove the blood textures, then I probably will end up with dirt textures instead. But I could try it. It would make the mod look better if they looked like they did in the beginning all the time. Some of the blood looks good, like this for example, when it's just small blood stains. It's not good when they are all blooded. See what the general is doing. Here's the general. Because the bodyguard is fighting, she has a hard time moving. Now it works fine. Sound the horn again. So we killed 100%. Nice. That's why it stopped to be a problem. So we entered the plaza with the general. Kill the final unit. I believe we have won now. Yeah, we won the battle. So we killed 100%, we killed 37%. We lost 467. We have 782 remaining. We killed 3,936, 79 while they were fleeing the battle. Russell, the Gorlock, the Sivich actually had lost 4,021 men. They were really bad. Enemies killed 529. Right. They clearly had the numerical advantage and they still lost. Yeah, it would be good to replace the projectile so we don't have that earthshake. Them have it and merge the units and army routes. Vidya trade increase, promising commander Vidya. Resistance is futile in rain speaker. Yeah, we used to conquer it. Vidya is a cruel leader. Yeah, the Naga are not nice, so we'll go for dirt roads in rain speaker. Can't do more this time unless we can move them already. Yeah, we can move. Let's leave a unit of Naga Ambers. No, we'll leave one of the Naga Sea Callers. There are more areas here. We can conquer this area. Another Gorlock army. Alright, we'll save this for later. I need to go and do some stuff. Save the game before the battle. So we are gonna fight the minor factions again. In the settlement of Mosswalker Village in Northrend, Vidya is the attacker still, same general as before, same army. The enemy is a Gorlok, minor factions, Gorloks, and he has the same force as the other army we just defeated. Two units of Gorlok mages plus the bodyguard, which is a Gorlok mage unit, and then they have Maluk swamp runners, javeliners, they have the mage here, the stats, and then they have the Maluk slaves, basic infantry, and they have the Maluk sword crawlers, better infantry. Both are using, I believe the slaves are using just a sword or knife, and the sword crawlers are using shield and sword, or shield and knife. And then we have the javeliners here, swamp runners. Then there is a, I believe, it's like a pike unit or a spear unit, spearman unit, but they don't have that here. Okay, we have all of them in the Naga roster, with the exception of the oracles, and they are counted as the militia of the Naga. Alright, we are ready to fight the battle. Let's save again, just to be sure, and see ya.